Hi everyone and welcome to today's video. I'm going to showcase the Tonic Craft Kit number 22. First we're going to take a quick look on what's included and then I'm going to make 3 cards and you will be able to see some of the products in action. First of all, you will get this mini ink cube. This is actually embossing ink, so you can use it with an embossing powder that is included in the kit. I'm going to show it to you later on. Now this is Nouveau Mousse in a lovely silver color. You can apply it with your spatula over stencils or just apply it with your finger like I'm going to do here. It shows beautifully over dark colored cardstock and it adds shine on white cardstock as well. You also get glitter accents. The color is Silver Jubilee and it's really shiny. It has glitter inside. And this is the full size product, so you don't get a mini version of it. Lots of product to use in many projects. This is a mini sparkle spray. The color is Apple Spritzer and I'm going to test it out on this black cardstock. These sprays are really sparkly, they show beautifully on both dark and lighter colored cardstock, and probably you can see that mica moving around. It's really gorgeous in real life. You will also get a full pack of alcohol markers. These are the Palma Violets, and I'm going to show you my color wheel so you can see which ones you are getting. These are the 3 ones down there. Their markers always come in pack of 3, so you always know that these 3 colors will blend beautifully together. Now you will also get a mini pot of embossing powder. The color is Shimmering Pearl. It's not going to add any color on your cardstock, it's just going to give a lovely shine on anything you are going to emboss. Now let's take a look on what's included in the envelope. So you will get tons of dies, of course the sticker that I always like to stick at the front. Let's take a quick look on the stamp set. You will get 2 flowers and a lovely sentiment in a beautiful font. And now let's take a look at the die set. This is a massive die set, tons and tons of dies that you can combine together. Just for the amount of dies, I think the kit is worth its money. Now this is a sentiment that says all my love, and there is also one more die to cut out its shadow. There is one more sentiment that says sending hugs, and again you will find a die that cuts out its shadow. There are 3 dies that match the stamps, so you will get one that cut out the sentiment and 2 that cut out the flowers. Now you get 2 dies that cut out ovals, one of them fit inside an A2 card. And you get lots and lots of dies that cut out beautiful designs to embellish your cards. Now you can see that you can mix and match these, everything fits inside something else. Some of the designs are perfect for everyday cards, some of them look like hollies, so you would be able to use them for Christmas cards. If you combine these dies, you are going to create beautiful frames, and I'm going to show you how you can use even the larger of these dies in a standard card size. This is the one that I'm talking about. It's just gorgeous with a beautiful leaf design all around. Use it partially if you don't want to create a big card, and I'm going to show you an example later on. Here's another die that fits inside that beautiful frame. You can use these dies to create frames and then you can nest inside your focal points or your sentiments. I think it's one of those die sets that are really versatile and you will be reaching out for it a lot. As always, you will get cardstock. There are 9 different colors. Some of them are really special. You will see that some are pearlescent, mirror cardstock, or even glitter cardstock. Let's start with the first card for today. I'm going to combine the green and the pearlescent cardstock. Both of these panels are 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm going to apply the larger of the dies on one side of the green cardstock. Now this is really big, it's not going to go through my die cutting machine, so I had to cut out one of the sides. Now I'm going to run it through and you will see the result. I get a beautiful panel, which I'm going to repeat on the rest of the green cardstock that I have left over. Now I am ready to put my card together, so with my trusted Nouveau Deluxe, I'm going to add a line of glue on the very edge of my panel. I'm going to stick down 2 thin strips of the violet cardstock that was included in the kit, and I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the excess. I have foam tape at the back of my green panels and I'm going to stick them down, making sure that I leave just a little bit of that purple background show through. For my sentiment, I went with a die that cuts out all my love, and I also die cut the shadow using the purple cardstock, and I'm going to stick both of these together. Now somehow I forgot my phone on camera, sorry about that. I usually don't have objects here and there when I'm crafting, just so it's not distracting for you guys. So anyway, I'm going to stick my sentiment on top, and I had some foam tape at the back. Here are some close-up photos on this card. And here is another idea. This die would work great on a gatefold card with those beautiful borders. Moving on to the second card, I'm going to use this die to cut out a window. This one is really gorgeous, you will end up with a beautiful frame. And I am going for a shaker card, so at the back I'm going all around the edge of the window and add tape adhesive. And at the top of it I'm going to add some acetate. I also went ahead and added foam tape all around the back of that frame, and for my shaker element I went with the hot pink stars, and the background is the glitter cardstock that was included in the kit, so it's really really shiny in real life. I also used the die that cuts out this beautiful sentiment that says sending hugs. I'm going to add Nouveau Deluxe at the back and stick it at the top of my window, just where that acetate is. With all that sparkle going on my card, I'm not going to do anything else on top of it. I think it's beautiful as it is. And the die that cuts out this window with that beautiful detail is my absolute favorite from the whole die set. Moving on to the last card for today, I'm going to combine three of the dies included, one inside the other. I'm going to run them through my die cutting machine and you can see the result. I end up with three die cuts. I will be using the outer one and the inside one. And I'm also going to use the flowers from the stamp set. I'm going to stamp them with my embossing ink that was included in the kit. And I'm going to apply on top the embossing powder from the kit as well. And you can see how lovely and sparkly it looks once it is set. And since they are included in the die set, I will use the matching dies to cut out these flowers. So here I have all my elements ready to go. I also used the oval die to cut out one of the green panels, and I'm going to stick everything together. I will use my Nouveau Deluxe at the back of the beautiful frame, and I'm going to stick it on top of the green cardstock. And this time I'm going to use the stamp for the sentiment that says love is all you need. And you can see that this stamp is going to lay nicely and fit inside that panel. I stamped my sentiment by using the embossing ink from the kit, and then I looked through my stash to find a violet embossing powder, which I had. So this is the one that I'm going to use, and that's just because I want to match the color of the flowers. But if you don't have such an embossing powder, you can always use any color of ink. So I'm going to heat set that. And now I'm going to put my card together. Again, I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe at the back of this panel. I'm going to stick it inside that frame, and you see it fits beautifully there. And then at the back of that oval, I'm going to add foam tape and stick it on top of my card base. So I have some dimension there. Now I'm going to stick the three flowers that I have, bigger and two smaller ones, on top of my card just to embellish it a little bit more. But these petals are not separated from each other, so that's what I'm doing with my scissors, just cutting a slit in between the petals. And this way I can curl up the petals with my fingers and make those flowers look more dimensional. So now I'm going to use my Nouveau Deluxe at the back and stick all the flowers down. And then to finish off my card and to embellish it a little bit more, I'm going to add some dots with crystal drops at the center of these flowers. And the color I'm using here is one of my favorites, which is called Ivory Seashell. It has a lovely shine. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. Don't forget, you will find all the links that you need down below in the description area. The kit is available for a few more days. And keep in mind that both the stamps and the dies are exclusive to this kit and you cannot get them separately. And these were the cards for today. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment, like and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you all so much for joining me, and I'll see you all next time.